Tonight, what's that smell on Sanibel? Many people on the beach are asking it, but it still remains a mystery. Now, we first told you about the red drift algae washing up on our beaches last Wednesday.
Yeah, and around that time, some beaches really started to stink, but experts tell us they don't think it's coming from the algae. Instead, they say it's coming from the water. They're trying to find exactly where the stench is coming from, but in the meantime, it has people leaving the spots like Tarpon Bay Beach before even setting up their towels and chairs. NBC2's Megan Miller is live there now. Megan, what are you seeing and smelling?
Well, the red drift algae is still lining the beach here. It's not everywhere on Sanibel, but here at Tarpon Bay, it's pretty bad. And the beach, it's empty. All day we've seen people trying to come set up here, then kind of just turning right back around. As the tide comes in, we can see that algae piling up here. That bad smell, almost like rotten eggs, lingering for days. Now, we have not confirmed if the algae and the smell are directly related, but the stench has people packing up.
Even when we got out of the car, we kind of noticed the smell.
And it's not the sea breeze you might expect when pulling up to the beach.
It smells like mold and dirty socks.
Like swamp, like a bad toilet odor.
You know, you can tell it's kind of a rotting, organic smell. It's not that fresh beach air that you expect.
We've been hearing about what you're smelling since last Wednesday. That's about the same time this red drift algae started showing up.
It's pretty much the welcome mat of the beach.
But it's not very welcoming.
It's not a pretty sight, or it doesn't make you want to go in the water.
On Thursday, Sanibel's Director of Natural Resources said the smell doesn't seem to be coming from the algae. He believes it's coming from the water. He says they're testing it. So far, they tell us there are no signs of red tide. It's relieving news to visitors who were here last year. This year, no dead fish or respiratory issues, but the smell.
I would say this year's the smell's a little bit worse.
Forcing some people to leave the impacted beaches.
We're just gonna go somewhere else where we don't get that smell.
We went to other spots on Sanibel, like Bowman's Beach. We found fewer chunks of the red drift algae and no unusual smell. We asked the city for an update to confirm if the two are related or not. We didn't get one, but we did run into a Sanibel councilwoman as she was inspecting the beach herself. She says we can expect a water quality update at Monday's council meeting.
We're doing the best we can to get the best understanding from our experts to help direct us. Water quality is our priority out here. We have that on our agenda at every meeting.
Now, tomorrow's meeting is open to the public. It starts at 9 a.m. at City Hall. Last we heard, the city does not have any plans to remove this red drift algae. They say it's because it's not the problem, and removing it might actually hurt wildlife. We're live on Sanibel Island. Megan Miller, NBC2.